Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for some good old Boeing and ULA bashing again. Of course, we're talking about the ULA Delta IV Heavy fails and the possible further postponing of the Boeing Starliner flights. Then of course, as always, we'll take a look at what's happening with the SpaceX Starship at Boca Chica.
Meanwhile at NASA, another week, another warning regarding Artemis. This time from the Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel. They found that Artemis faces technical and budgetary risks. Big surprise here. And poor Jim Bridenstine had to go through another Senate hearing. But at least SLS will get the old school NASA warm logo. Then we also have some news on China. They want to launch the first space mining robot in November. And what's up with that super secret Chinese space plane? A lot to talk about again, so stay tuned.
It's time to talk about the continued launch failings of the Delta IV Heavy. They keep trying to launch this rocket since weeks now, but every time shortly before launch, it keeps getting scrubbed. Now already for the fifth time. ULA is attempting to launch a spy satellite for the National Reconnaissance Office, which is valued at around $1 billion. So their continued failings to launch this $1 billion piece of hardware, of course, doesn't shine a light of competence onto ULA. So what is the cause for these continued delays? Well, we have to remain fair and say that it's not entirely ULA's fault. Delta IV Heavy is using a very old launch complex, namely Complex 37 at Kennedy Space Center, which was built already in 1959. ULA took over Launch Complex 37B about 20 years ago and modified it to be able to launch Delta IV Heavy rockets, the first of which launched back in November 2002. So the pad is really old, and on top it is used very infrequently, only about a rocket launch per year on average. So much for the launch pad. But of course the fact that the Delta IV Heavy rocket is about to be retired soon, in order to make place for the more cost-effective Vulcan Centaur, could also play a role. The Delta IV Heavy has only a few more launches left, and maybe technicians at ULA were a bit too negligent with this old piece of rocket hardware, directing too much attention and focus towards the new Vulcan Centaur. The Vulcan Centaur will be the first ULA rocket where parts can be reused. Namely, the engines might possibly be retrieved after use, but this is not 100% certain yet. It will have less payload capacity than a Falcon Heavy, namely 27 metric tons to LEO, so not even half the Falcon Heavy's 65 metric tons. But hey, at least it will cost a lot less than the Falcon Heavy. Up to $200 million according to current estimates, compared to Falcon Heavy's $90 million in reusable and $150 million in expandable mode. Anyways, let's hope that ULA will be able to get the Delta IV Heavy off the ground, because we don't want to be asses here. I mean, those guys have enough problems as it is.
Same as Boeing, by the way, where ULA, which is a joint venture of Boeing and Lockheed, at least has the excuse of an old launch pad. Boeing doesn't have an excuse for Starliner. It's 100% entirely their own fault. And NASA's Aerospace Safety and Advisory Council, short ASAP, is wondering whether Boeing will be able to launch the next planned unmanned Starliner flight on time. We remember that the last unmanned Starliner flight took place in December 2019, which almost ended in disaster, as was later found out by NASA. NASA then gave Boeing a total of 80 recommendations in order to fix the issues. 80 recommendations! So the next try for an unmanned or a crewed test flight. Actually, we aren't allowed to say unmanned anymore. You know, PC obsession with semantics? So yes, the next unmanned test flight with Starliner was scheduled for December this year. But now it appears that this date might slip further, as ASAP found. The first mission with astronauts on board of Starliner would have taken place in June 2021. But as it looks now, all these dates might slip further. And please consider subscribing to us. because we are one of the only few channels that dare to openly bash Boeing, Lockheed and Blue Origin and call out their incompetence. We really need your support and thank you very much.
SpaceX, meanwhile, will launch the Crew 1 mission on October 31st, so this will be a Halloween launch, and the Crew 2 mission is already scheduled for March 2021. So while SpaceX will have had already 3 manned missions to the ISS with Crew Dragon, Boeing will not have launched astronauts even once. Yes, dear PC friends, this also includes women to the ISS, not even once. Then of course the question arises why NASA would need Starliner at all, especially considering that a seat on Starliner will cost around $90 million, around twice as much as a seat on SpaceX's Crew Dragon. Now sure, Crew Dragon also had its fair share of problems, but SpaceX is a company that is only 17 years old and is building completely new radical hardware, and they always resolve the problems quite quickly. But then again, we assume it's good to have a choice. Even though it appears more and more that this second choice to Crew Dragon might materialize a few years later than expected. And then let's see if Boeing will even be able to compete with SpaceX anymore. We highly doubt it. And this will certainly not help Boeing with the talent drain they are experiencing right now.
Quite contrary to SpaceX, which is now facing a talent overflow. So at Boca Chica, SpaceX is continuing to press forward with the Starship program. Starship SN8 has been lifted to the launch mount. It still has the rear body flaps folded, and still no nosecone and forward flaps. But maybe the nosecone will be installed after the upcoming cryo-proof tests in the next days. So with luck, we can see nosecone and static fire next week. Let's see. And we are really careful doing any time estimates regarding the upcoming hop. We are hoping for October. But hey, at least work on the Super Heavy booster is starting for real now. The forward dome section has been sleeved now, as you can see here. And as always, a big thank you to Mary, aka Boca Chica Girl, for these amazing shots. And please also go and check out NASA Spaceflight's YouTube channel and subscribe to them. The Super Heavy high bay looks similar to last time, but the roof is almost finished now. And the Super Heavy launch pad, or orbital launch pad, as it is also called, is progressing further as well, as you can see here. For us, the most amazing part is that work on the Super Heavy booster is really picking up speed. The booster is an essential part of the whole Starship Super Heavy launch architecture. Because without the booster, no orbital flight.
Meanwhile at NASA, another week, another hearing or warning. A warning from ASAP, you know, the guys we mentioned before, they just love to warn people about stuff. Anyways, they warned that NASA faces technical and budgetary risks to the Artemis program. No surprise here, we often talked in detail about the fact that without a drastic increase in NASA funding for 2021 and the following years, NASA will likely just not have enough funds to carry out the Artemis manned and, of course, womanned moon landings by 2024. Because they need $28 billion in addition to the current budget on top until 2025 to make it happen. Jim Bridenstine, meanwhile, is continuing to fight the epic fight in order to secure enough funding for the 2024 moon landing. He already had to endure such a hearing last week, about which we talked in this video here.
Now this week, on September the 30th, Jim Bridenstine tried to convince members of the Senate Commerce, Science and Transportation Committee during the hearing to enable enough funding for Artemis. Even though many representatives on both sides of the political spectrum were supportive, such as Democrat Senator Maria Cantwell or Republican Senator Roger Wicker, still no decision could be reached on how to progress with Artemis. It seems that for the time being, NASA will still maintain the 2020 funding levels, and maybe with luck, get the 2021 funding approved sometime early next year, which they would need to further progress with the human landing systems for Artemis 3. The human landing systems require an additional $3.2 billion funding in 2021. Of course, we will keep you updated on the progress. And let's hope that NASA gets the necessary budget. Else, we probably won't see a NASA-like return to the moon in 2024. Luckily, this whole budget discussion has no influence on a SpaceX-like return to the moon with Starship, as you know. But at least the SLS solid rocket boosters got the old-school NASA red worm logo, as you can see here. It's cool somehow. We don't know why, but we really like it.
And now China. What is China up to with their secret space plane? About a month ago, China launched a new experimental reusable space plane on September 3rd on a Long March 2F rocket. China is of course very secretive about it, so we just have some speculative renders showing a space plane which is very similar to the Boeing X-37B space plane, of which two specimens exist and are currently owned by the Air Force, which have spent a total of 2,865 days in orbit already, all missions having been of course classified. So China doesn't want to be left out of the cool space plane game, and they too are now apparently testing a reusable space plane. Hopefully we will find out more about the capabilities and intentions of the Chinese space plane program. In non-secretive space news, China wants to launch the first asteroid mining robot in November.
The Chinese company Origin Space will launch NEO-1, a 30-kilogram light satellite on a Long March rocket in November. Yu Tianhong, co-founder of Origin Space, said that the goal is to verify and demonstrate multiple functions, such as spacecraft orbital maneuver, simulated small celestial body capture, intelligent spacecraft identification and control. So this is not a real asteroid mining mission yet, only to test the systems. But if everything goes according to plan, Origin Space will move forward with prototype mining probes, which will be sent to near-Earth asteroids in the coming years. As you know, there are insanely valuable resources on asteroids. 16 Psyche alone, an asteroid in the asteroid belt, contains so much precious metals as to be worth hundreds, possibly even thousands of quadrillions of dollars. Yes, quadrillions. So of course, China is very interested to enter the space mining game, which will be a gigantic new market in the upcoming decades.
And if you want to know what could happen if NASA doesn't get enough funding for the human landing systems, and if China could even land on the moon before NASA, you can watch this video here where we talked about it.
But not before SpaceX.
No, not before SpaceX, of course.
So thanks for watching the JS Space Report, and I would say, on to the future.
Bist du so knuffig?
Now check the recording and then yes. Bye.